up, everybody? It's Scotty from Imonolith. This week's riff lesson, I think I'm going to do something a little bit different. I got inspired recently by John and Ryan did a live Instagram feed, and they were talking about their inspirations and their influences and how they got into music and how it helped grow their career. Well, in my experience, this is the most important band to me, especially as a bass player. This is Primus. Especially this album, Same with the Seas of Cheese. And today, I thought that I would do... Let's see if I can do this properly. I thought it would be rad if I went over one of my favorite songs on Same with the Seas of Cheese. It's a song called American Life. It's one of the easier of all of the hard Primus songs. I guess I'll play through it a couple times and then break it down. And hopefully I'm actually playing it properly. It sounds like it when I'm playing it with the album. So if I screw up or or I'm not playing it properly, definitely shoot me a message in the comments or whatever. Let me know, let me know your take. Maybe you guys play it differently or whatever. But here's my take on American Life by Primus. I'll just do the main riff, I guess, and just going into the chorus section. It's in standard tuning. So just E, A, D, G. And it's all in G minor, I guess. So here we go. So that's the riff. It is pretty fucking awesome. I wish I wrote it, but that would be the genius of Mr. Les Claypool. If you guys haven't heard that song, listen to American Life by Primus. The syncopation between Tim Alexander, the drummer, and Les Claypool, the bass player, is absolutely insane. And then when you double it up that Les is also singing the song while he's playing bass, it's a head fuck for sure. But so I'll just break down the technique that I'm doing. It starts off on the downbeat of every riff by just hitting a low G, your third fret of your E string. Then it gets really tricky. It has a lot to do with this hand, but I'll break it down separately. So on the fretting hand, you go to your D string, and it's a hammer-on open 3-5. And then the tricky one is the second section is a open G, third fret on G to the fifth fret on D. So it's actually a... So the riff actually goes... And then this hand is doing all the nonsense, so maybe I can show it a little bit better. It's a flamenco-style bass playing, which is not normal at all, but Les stole it from Geddy, who stole it from Stanley Clark, etc., and it goes all the way back. So the riff on this hand is you're essentially strumming like this motion up and down the strings, and you're just going... And as you get up to speed, it starts to sound obviously a lot more like the song. The second pre-chorus section is just a power chord down on your first fret on your D string, third fret on your G string. Same thing with the flamenco hand, is you're hitting a lot of ghost notes, so you're kind of bouncing. This is hard to see, but I'm bouncing on the fret as I'm strumming like this. So I'm doing... And it creates this almost like back and forth kind of sound where I'm going. And then back into the riff. A little flub on that one, but whatever. So I'll play it up to speed. Hopefully I've explained this well enough that maybe you guys can try this out. If you haven't heard of Primus, I really encourage you and everybody to check out Primus. They're absolutely amazing. Les Claypool also has a new band with Sean Lennon called the Claypool Lennon Delirium, and it's Pink Floyd on even more acid. It's like the music that's probably going on, that was going on in Syd Barrett's head after he left Pink Floyd. Just whirly bird nonsense. Anyway, I always digress. One more time through the riff just for you guys. Sloppy ass ending. I fucking love all of you guys. This is Scotty from Imonolith signing off. That's this week's Riff Lesson. Take care. Stay safe.